Most people know Tatyana Ali as the actress who played Ashley Banks on The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air. She was described as being one of the most beautiful entertainers on television. So it's really no surprise that she has had relationships with some of the most desirable men in Hollywood. But when she was ready to finally experience true love, she found exactly what she was looking for right there on her computer screen. Don't forget, you can gain access to this audio and one unreleased video per month on the RRG Patreon. Details are in the description box. Now, grab some popcorn and let's get into today's video. Tatyana Ali was born in New York to an Afro-Panamanian mother and an Indo-Trinidadian father. She attended Marymount High School in Los Angeles, an all-girls private school where one of her classmates was Kim Kardashian. Later on, she transferred to the Buckley School in Sherman Oaks. In 1993, 14-year-old Tatyana was attending a friend's Halloween party when she was introduced. He would receive 4,000 letters from fans per week, and his image was plastered on the cover of almost every teen magazine. According to People magazine, he introduced himself to Tatyana, but nothing really came of that first meeting. Jonathan had to fly out to Orlando to film the TV show Sequest, and Tatyana remained in Los Angeles. They would occasionally run into each other since they had a lot of mutual friends. In the summer of 1995, he dropped by her house a few times since his parents lived just 15 minutes away from her parents. But Tatyana was apprehensive. She told People magazine he was older, probably a lot more experienced. It was uncomfortable. Jonathan could feel the tension, so he told her he was going to stop visiting her and told her, "You're going to miss me." And he was right. Tatyana said she picked up the phone and called him the very next morning. Their parents approved of their relationship, which made things much easier for them. Her mom described Jonathan as sweet, kind, and sincere, while Jonathan's mom said their family loved Tatyana. The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air ended in 1996. And that same year, she and Jonathan starred in a made-for-TV movie called Fall into Darkness. While their relationship was getting stronger and stronger, they had a few issues to deal with. During a night out at a restaurant, Jonathan said a black man walked up to Tatyana and told her, "I watch your show all the time, but now that I see you letting this white man date you, I will never watch your show again." Tatyana told People magazine, "It hurt me that someone could disrespect what I thought was so special." But she insisted that People's reaction to her interracial relationship only brought her and Jonathan closer together. After graduating from high school in 1997, Tatyana decided to take her career in another direction. She got signed to the King of Pop's MJJ music label. She headed to the studio to work with some of the industry's most talented producers and musicians, such as Sean Stockman of Boyz II Men, Rodney Jerkins, and Vincent Herbert. Her 1998 album, Kiss the Sky, included the bubblegum pop songs Boy, You Knock Me Out and Daydreamin'. Both singles were certified gold. She headed out on tour with NSYNC, and while enjoying the success of her new music career, her relationship with Jonathan was slowly falling apart. During her appearance on a documentary called Boulevard of Broken Dreams, Tatyana said,
"He's a very emotional person and very explosive. Very."
Tatyana was enjoying her transition to adulthood, but Jonathan was said to be struggling. After Sequest ended in 1996, he landed a role on a 1997 TV movie. But after that, his acting gigs came to a screeching halt. He went from being on top of the world to not knowing where his career would take him or how he would make ends meet.
When you've been on covers of magazines for years, when that stops happening, like, what's your identity? When that was your identity.
She and Jonathan broke up in 1998. And Tatyana headed off to Harvard University. She told the Working Author website she had been in the entertainment industry for so long, she just wanted to socialize with people her own age. But after being stuck sitting in front of a computer all day and spending most of her time in the library, she was itching to head back out into the real world. She graduated early with a degree in political science and African American studies. No longer consumed by her school books, she reportedly had a brief fling with Justin Timberlake in 2003. And in November of that year, her entire world crumbled. On November 11, 2003, Jonathan attempted to take his own life. His friend found him in the hallway of his apartment and called 911. Jonathan was raced to the hospital, but sadly, he didn't recover from his injuries. The next day, he was pronounced deceased at the age of 27.
A mutual friend of ours called me, and I just fell out.
Tatyana continued with her acting career and had roles in music videos and television shows like Buppies, The Young and the Restless, and Second Generation Weigh-ins. And when she wasn't working, she told the HuffPost that she had a weakness for one-night stands. She also addressed the rumors that she was only interested in being with a white man. Tatyana said she was an equal opportunity type of person, but she couldn't believe people still cared about the race of the man she was dating. She just wanted someone who was intelligent, kind, funny, and passionate about their work. She was linked to comedian Eric Andre at one point, but it appeared she had found her perfect match in 2013. 34-year-old Tatyana was seen partying with 26-year-old Drake at a Los Angeles nightclub. According to sources, they were celebrating Tatyana's birthday and left the nightclub together. 2 months later, she appeared on the Wendy Williams show and spilled some details about that night. She said Drake bought her a beautiful bottle of champagne at the club and he made her feel very special. Wendy decided to cut to the chase.
Have you hooked up with him?
I think he's amazing. I think he's awesome. I didn't know what? Girl!
We still don't know if they had an intimate encounter, but we do know that by 2014, she had moved on with someone else. Unbeknownst to us, Tatyana signed up for eHarmony, an online dating website. She was matched with a man named Dr. Vaughn Raspberry, an associate professor and the director of undergraduate studies at Stanford University. She told Entertainment Tonight they exchanged messages back and forth for months before agreeing to chat with each other on Skype. Their first real date was the start of a beautiful relationship, and at some point, Vaughn decided Tatyana was the one. He took her on a 45-minute hike in Yosemite, which was her favorite location, and that's where he got down on one knee and proposed. As they started planning their wedding, she found out she was pregnant. Learning that they were about to be first-time parents made them shift perspectives. Tatyana said they wanted their wedding ceremony to celebrate their newest blessing. They became husband and wife in July 2016 during an intimate ceremony in Beverly Hills. 2 months later, she gave birth to their son, Edward. And in October 2019, they welcomed their second son, Alejandro. These days, Tatyana and Vaughn's marriage appears to be stronger than ever. In an Instagram post, she described him as being kind, generous, brilliant, and super sexy. She added, "You are my son. I am so blessed to share this life with you." The couple will celebrate their fifth wedding anniversary in 2021, and we wish them a lifetime of love and happiness. Let us know your thoughts on Tatyana Ali's dating history, and thanks for watching Real Reality Gossip.